Man, I've been blessed to be married to a beautiful and loving wife for 24 years. And I tell you what, here's some things I've learned over that. Marriage is beautiful, it's challenging, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. This past Sunday, we continued. We're now in our fifth week of this sermon series called Resounding Hope. And we're walking through the book of 1 Peter. And if you missed the sermon in its entirety, go back and watch it on demand so that you can catch up with what we're learning together. But if you were in the worship service this past week and experienced the time together studying God's Word, you'll know that we looked at 1 Peter chapter 3, verses 1 through 7, which frankly is a very challenging passage of Scripture because it speaks to marriage and the roles of the husband and the roles of the wife in a way that, let's just be honest, aren't necessarily accepted in today's culture without any conflict, because I would say that's often described or met with maybe a little bit of resistance, because the ideas that are presented are either misunderstood or have been misused over time. And we talked about that a little bit in the sermon. But one thing that we started with was the very first word in 1 Peter chapter 3 is likewise. That then causes us to go all the way back and read or refresh some things that were written previously in chapter 2, where we see the example of humility that Christ demonstrates for us. And then we recognize our need to honor those around us for the sake of the gospel. And so the conduct or the behavior and attitudes that are challenged in verses 1 through 7 of 1 Peter chapter 3 are in that same spirit. So as I reflect on that this morning, here's what I challenge you to consider. It's very similar to the words that we read in Romans chapter 12, verses 1 and 2, when Paul is writing, he says, I urge you, therefore, brothers, sisters, fellow believers, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing unto the Lord. This is your spiritual act of worship. Verse 2, and do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, and then you will be able to prove. So, and it goes on to the following verses. Do not be conformed to the world, I think, is the pause and the correlation to what we learn and are reminded of in 1 Peter chapter 3. Because you and I live in a rhythm of a culture, especially in a Western-minded culture that pervades America, that contradicts sometimes the design of God's plan and intention, not just about marriage, but the way we treat other people, the way we serve other people, the way we demonstrate the character, love of God, loving our neighbor and our enemy. Those things are truthfully counterintuitive to what has become the norm of culture. And the challenge for us is to learn every single day, beginning today, to evaluate how we live our life and every relationship that we have with our employee, with our neighbor, with our spouse, and in our home, and reevaluate those relationships through the lens of what God says about them, how we should love, how we should serve, how we should honor. So at the end of the day, when we just simply, at first glance, we read some verses like 1 Peter 3, verses 1 through 7, it may cause us to scratch our head, like this sounds weird. Well, truthfully, it's okay that it sounds weird, because it is pushing against what is the cultural norm, which is really what Jesus was trying to do from the very beginning. So I encourage you today, as you walk through this life, whether you're married, whether you're single, doesn't matter your relational context today, I urge you and challenge you to live out Romans 12, 1 and 2 today, realizing that your behavior and your conduct is an opportunity to demonstrate submission to Christ, and the way you serve others to demonstrate the hope of the gospel in the prayerful desire that others will see your good deeds and glorify your Father who is in heaven. Hey, I hope you're encouraged today. I can't wait to hear the stories of you living out this week. So as you do so, share them with me. I'd love to hear your stories. Check out more information about who we are as a church and even the sermon that I referred to on our website. And I sure hope to hear from you soon. Be blessed and have a great week.